As planned, we started this vivid update on our boat on New Year's Eve. While watching fireworks out the window, we celebrated the new year, knowing our adventure was just about to begin. We waved goodbye to our friends at Brunswick Landing and headed out to sea. So this evening we've been traveling to St. Augustine. And we thought we were going to just do this with an overnight anchor somewhere on the way, but it's unusually calm, so calm that it almost looks like you're not in the ocean at all. So we decided to go overnight, and we've been motoring for, a dozen hours or more, and not that far out, just maybe 5-6 miles off the coast, and we're pretty close to St. Augustine, so. Looks like it's going to be a nice sunrise when we arrive, and again, the seas are just beautiful, so I can't wait for the sunrise to come up. It's going to be something. And another fun thing is St. Augustine also has a really great light out there. Yeah, a lighthouse. It's a lighthouse, so it's kind of made it easier to find out where we're headed, even though, of course, we have the charts. That's what we're doing today. All right, we made it. We are anchored in the mooring field here in beautiful St. Augustine. We've got a great spot, this beautiful sunrise. Background is the fort. Off to the right is downtown St. Augustine. Flagler, all in there. It's going to be a great place for us to hang out. So, good for us. Can't get much better weather than this, and a much better place to have a sunrise, cup of coffee. Cheers. Here we are at the fort. And there is Pippin. We're that close. We have front row seats to the most popular attraction here in St. Augustine. And what a beautiful day. Here we are. There it is.
Here we are in downtown St. Augustine. Nothing suspicious about us. We're just walking to the hardware store, and my husband has a huge propane canister in the back of his backpack. But at least it's pretty. So we are on our way to find some lunch here in St. Augustine and some fuel. And there's a great shop here called the Sailor's Exchange, which is like a thrift shop for sailors, so we're going to check that out too. Heading back to the boat.
Success. We have arrived with a propane. Mission accomplished for the day. I'm not sure they're all here to take our picture, but maybe they are. Maybe I should wave. Tour boats have been going by here all night for this special showing of the lights.
We are departing our comfortable, beautiful mooring in St. Augustine. This morning it was about 43 degrees when we woke up, and among other things, we were desiring some warmth from being further south, but we also want to start making our way down the coast, and we'll see how this transit goes. We are staying inside today on the ICW. Seas were a little bit questionable outside, and there's really no other way to get in to the waterway once you get out there unless you go 50 some miles, so we thought this was safer, but we are all comfy with our gloves on, our coffee in hand.
Catch fish because the fish are jumping out of the water. That's crazy. That is totally crazy. Dolphins are catching fish while we're just hanging out, watching the sunset. Doesn't get much better than that.
We have arrived.
Freeze this. Too windy to sail, our friends Bill and Jess invited us out to a karaoke-like sing-with-the-band type place. We had no idea Bill the Sailor was such a crazy good singer, and rocking the house is what he's about to do.
Yeah.
get some fresh produce. Good stuff.
I've got a black with a turtle on it.
All right, so we're off the boat today, and or tonight, we're in Titusville. And the reason is that there's a SpaceX launch.
Oh, never mind.
Over there is where the boat is. Over here. Well, that's where the launch is. Hard to see in the picture here, but here I can actually see the flame behind the rocket. Good morning. We are at the famous anchorage of Lake Worth, just north of Palm Beach. This is a place where people commonly leave to go to the Bahamas. And we're always waiting for the best weather. And right now, this could be the day. It's looking really flat. I don't know if you can see behind me here. There's no waves, there's no wind. In fact, we can see some of our neighbors over here, over there. Looks like they're getting ready as well. Checking out their sails and that sort of thing. So we're gonna go check the weather and check our to-do list. And sometime in the next 24 hours, we might actually make our crossing. So we'll see what happens.
Well, that's it for this update. Next time we will update you from the Bahamas. See you then.